Or the actual video that's uploaded eventually will start. So maybe you're coming in right now. I don't know. But I'm Johnny DeRoll. The show is starting now. The full show is coming up in about 50 minutes. I'm going to be joined, as always, on Fridays by Brett Ehrlich, which is going to be a lot of fun, not only because we've got a ton of news, including the launch of the impeachment trial. It is coming. It's not here just yet, but it is coming. More Biden action, some pretty hilarious Fauci video, and our garbage people of the week. Brett's got one. I don't know what it is. I've got one that's a bit more on the subtle side, but it makes me feel sick all the same, and I'm going to find out what the TDR community chose as well. But before we get to all of that, I have got a lot of news that we have to cover. Can I start off with something a little bit lighter, I guess? Oh, Nom de Plume found a fellow Damage Report watcher on Reddit. What do you know? By the way, if you're already here, as several hundred of you are, thank you for hitting the like button. Please do that so that more people know we're active. Hopefully that'll work. So this is the sort of sad news, although tinged with a little bit of meh. Dave Chappelle has tested positive for COVID and is going to quarantine as a result of that. I haven't seen anything about his actual condition. There's nothing there to indicate that he's in particularly bad shape, and I certainly hope that he's not, because he's among my favorite comedians. There's two negative sides to this, though. One is he was doing a 10-day residency in Texas, which has been really hard hit by COVID. That's not necessarily the best idea. I know that people want to go back to normal, but, you know, it might potentially expose you to COVID, which it did. So that sucks. And I like Dave Chappelle. I don't want him to get COVID. The other side is there's, like, some reason to believe that he might have been infected by Elon Musk or Grimes, because they were photographed together just like a little bit ago, and apparently Grimes was sick and then just like immediately went back out and started like unmasked hanging out with people. I have no idea. This is not an assertion that it actually happened, but it ain't impossible that it happened. How weird and random would that be? Anyway, so yeah, Dave Chappelle has got COVID. That's terrible. I just saw an acknowledgement in the chat that Hank Aaron died. I sort of just assumed that Hank Aaron must have passed a while ago, because it's just from such a different era. But I guess he's younger than some current serving politicians. So I guess I was off on that, and certainly a major loss. One of the biggest stars in American sports history. Okay, let's see. Exoteric Dragon says, just wishing you love and health, brother. You help keep us together. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate that. I'm doing pretty good, though, actually. I'm a little bit nervous about the period that we're entering into, both because it's a period with a lot of opportunity, which means it also is a potential for wasted opportunity, and the Democrats are in control. In control of the presidency, the Senate, and the House, which I don't believe they have been ever while I've been doing this. This is the first period. They've had control of some of those things along the way, and now we have all of this opportunity, but it's still them. So I like feel a little bit sick, like every day we're gonna be watching to see how they botch this thing, and there's already some indications that that might happen. There's some good signs as well. Chuck Schumer seems to be indicating that he's possibly in support of ending the filibuster. If they do that, then they can accomplish many things. Except that there's still Joe Manchin. If they don't do that, then, yeah, I'm not feeling great about the near future. So I'm going to be doing a lot of thinking. I'm going to be, obviously, you know, we're still going to be doing this. We're going to be covering the news and everything. But I want to be doing some meta thinking about the path forward, about what the best use of this platform of TDR can be to try to manage this time that we're entering into. Rob Shively says, have you checked out WandaVision yet? I just saw that it was actually filmed in front of a live studio audience. That's funny. I like that they did that. I would say I've only watched those first two episodes. I enjoyed it. I actually kind of like that old school sitcom thing. I'm not against that, the sort of cheesy humor and stuff like that. I think that, is this going to be controversial? I think that Vision has been fine. I think that Wanda is the show. I think that she's performing perfectly in that style of like the, you know, 100 years ago, but like 70 years ago female comedian. I think she's doing a good job. I want to see where this goes and I want it to evolve, but it's been interesting so far. Selena S, welcome to tier two. Anything for Selena S. And by the way, the top 10 political formative moments of myself and Francesca Fiorentini is up for our level two and level three members. So enjoy that. Body Bailey says, keep up the great work. Love my fellow dragons. Can I be Nana Dragon Dragon Daddy? You can't. That's a long one, but you can. Socially Democrat says, why did ChopTYT only make the Bernie Mittens shirt in a long sleeve? I want a hoodie or t-shirt, please. Ask them if they can get it. That's a good point. I didn't know that we had that at all. They don't tell me most things. It seems like it would be a natural for a hoodie if the whole thing is about the cold weather. Selena S, your super chat message says it's retracted. But thank you for the super chat. I do appreciate that. Seesaw Chip says, given how Dems handled the ACA when they had the majority, I don't have a lot of faith in them. Yes. Yeah. And that was an incredibly long, drawn out process that didn't need to be nearly as drawn out as it was. That's certainly true. They did pass it. Let's bear that in mind. And for all that, like, there are few networks in the world that have done more criticism of the ACA than us, the situation pre-ACA was an absolute disaster, and the Republicans were never going to do anything about it. So it at least shows that they're willing to address the problems, just not necessarily at all in the way or to the scale that we would necessarily want. Okay, I'm going to do some more news. Let's see. Okay, because we have a lot. You know what? Let me go to the title story. So if you clicked on this because of the mention of Kellyanne Conway, I've got that for you. And so what is this? Well, this is something I saw on Axios. They said, this is what they say. If there's currency in this town, it's power. So we've asked several former Washington power brokers to share their best advice as a new administration, a new Congress settle into their jobs. So I don't think that anyone in this new administration is interested in Kellyanne Conway's advice. And so, but that might sound like I'm criticizing Axios for setting this up as if it's supposed to be helpful when they know damn well that nobody's gonna want that help. But I don't think that's what this is about. This is just, hey Kellyanne, tell us what you want them to do from Axios, which feels to me like just an attempt to maintain a relationship with Kellyanne Conway. This is like, this feels to me like the ultimate in access journalism. Just give me whatever you say, what you want me to say. I'll say nice things about you. We maintain the relationship. But this is what we've got. So here's what she has to say. And I love this stuff. Power should be used sparingly, yet strategically. That's your philosophy? That's the philosophy that you had for 4 years under Trump. A reluctance to exert power is also a necessary requisite for possessing it. Our Constitution reserves many powers to the individual and to the states. Washington often forgets that. Leaders are wise to respect, not rob, people of their power. Your guy just tried to literally steal the election. You kept kind of quiet about it, for the most part, but that was your team. They still wish that they could have been able to do that. People died in their attempt to do that. Leaders are wise to respect, not rob people of their power, unless that is designed to literally be a criticism of the guy that you were working for. It is the most hypocritical statement of supposed political philosophy that I can imagine, that you would say that any word of that is true of the team that you worked on. And if it isn't true, if they so directly countered everything you claim to believe about the way politics should work, about the way power should be wielded, about the respect and deference due to the people and to the states and presumably to those who are currently out of power, then you should have vented yourself from that team a long time ago. It's absolute BS, but it serves two purposes. So one is it helps her. She's leaving, and she would probably really prefer that you forget about all that Trump stuff that he did and that she was involved in, and the collusion, delusion, extrusion thing, all the lies, the Bowling Green massacre. She would really prefer if you guys would forget that. It's It's disrespectful of you guys to remember all that. So, on the way out, I believe in a responsible use of power, only where needed and never more than is needed. No, no, I know who you are. I know who you are, Kellyanne Conway. She had this to say, the late British Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher offered words to live by. Being powerful is like being a lady. If you have to tell people you are, you aren't. This is true. Show it. Don't say it. Use it wisely. Don't underline it obnoxiously. Kellyanne Conway, politely I ask, go F yourself. Because that's bullshit. First of all, if... I get she's a conservative. If you're going to make that point... No, quote Tywin Lannister, not Margaret Thatcher. They make the same point. But more importantly, oh, so this is what you... This is what your team was about. Show it. Don't say it. Use it wisely. Don't underline it obnoxiously. Trump has literally never done a thing that wasn't at least mildly obnoxious, first of all. Exercise of power, 100% included in that. But in terms of saying it, like, how many times did he say, it's a thing called Article 2. You can do anything you want with Article 2. No. Such goddamn lies. But there's a little bit more in this puff piece. If you have a choice between power and influence, go for influence. Power is conferred by one's birth, position, promotion, or election. Influence is how things get done. Preferring negotiation, persuasion, and elevating cooperation and collaboration. That's what was going on? Yeah, Trump was like, okay, here's the thing. Trump could have gotten way more done, but he didn't. But it ain't because of a preference for collaboration and the wise strategic use of power. It's because he's the fucking laziest person in America in the last 100 years. Dude couldn't be bothered to do anything beyond unwrapping a Whopper, ordering a Diet Coke, and turning on Fox News. That's it. Besides that, he had no real goals because he's a dummy. He had no real drive because he is fucking lazy. He was dumb and lazy, and so he accomplished basically nothing. He did a lot of damage. In terms of conservative, like, policy goals, what did they do? They passed the tax cuts. That was a gigantic problem. But the thing is, he also didn't need to, because again, like, you can wisely and strategically use your power when you don't want anything to be done because you don't have any problems because you're the most wealthy, powerful people in the country. Problems are for poor people. Rich people just want more riches. That's it, because riches solve every problem. Riches fix everything. They have that, and they got trillions more of it with Donald Trump giving them those tax cuts. And then after that, he could basically just slide. No, if you get in, at least ostensibly, at the head of a movement for regular people who are actually suffering and have real problems that require real solutions, then you need to actually wield your fucking power. That's what you need to do. You don't get to just be lazy and just slide from one fast food meal to the next. We need to actually solve these problems because we can't just sit back and count our billions. That's not a thing we can actually do. And so I don't know which aspect of this bothers me the most. The fact that Axios just lets her print whatever she wants, the fact that we're not going to actually hold her accountable for the fact that it has no bearing on what she actually did when she was in power, let alone what her team did, or the fact that it, like, if people were to believe the philosophy that she's saying there, then that implicitly benefits conservatives who want to effectively serve as a block on government function. That's it. You occasionally start a war because that gives money to the military-industrial complex, pass trillions of dollars in tax cuts because that gives direct money to the richest people in the country, and then just sit on your laurels because you don't want the government to do anything. Kellyanne Conway. Do you think she's coming back at some point? Is she going to be, like, working for Ted Cruz or something? Didn't she hate Trump initially? So many of them did. Anyway, Bernie Hard Dragon says, love you. I'm sick and stuck at home alone with kids and waiting for COVID results. Wish us luck. I remember. Best of luck to you. Really hope that you get through this smoothly. Silver Dragon says, how about dragon masks? I like it. I think we talked about that at one point. Maybe. Pamela Swanwick, welcome to Tier 1 membership. Enjoy the emojis, including the new Bernie meme emoji. I can't believe how fast they produced that. Now you can put Bernie anywhere you want as long as where you want him is in the YouTube chat. I love seeing him. Anthony Thornsbury says, do you think that there should be an income cap for people who run for office or representatives aren't part of the 1%? Look, I don't think that you can, I don't think that constitutionally you can have an income cap or anything like that. What I think we should have is a population that is inherently suspicious of wealthy people. It's not to say that every wealthy person is awful or duplicitous or anything like that, but we need to understand that to the extent that there could be a different species of humanity, the ultra wealthy are that species. It doesn't mean that they can't ever be aligned with us or can't ever be working towards the same goals as us, but that requires evidence. It cannot be assumed. And especially when it comes to people who want to personally exercise power, we should be suspicious of that. Again, it's not to say that they're all bad, but we get to question the motivations of millionaires and billionaires and what they're truly working for. And if what they say they're working for is one thing, but the obvious consequence of what they're working for is more money for millionaires and billionaires, my natural predilection is to say, I don't give a fuck what you say. I see what you're getting. I see what the outcome of this is. Ghost Dog says, Kellyanne Conway will get her own section in Trump's library called Alternative Facts. Well, she will be enshrined in that. Nicole, welcome to Tier 1 YouTube membership. Thank you for supporting the network this way. I really do appreciate that. Derpasaurus, thank you for your super chat. Love your icon. Ty Johnson says, my wife loves the show. Well, thank you, Ty, and Ty's wife. Joe Elizaiah Lakio Johnson, welcome to Tier 1 membership. Appreciate you supporting the show. Okay, I'm going to jump into another story in just a sec. Let's see. Jeff Rutherford said, Kellyanne Conway thinking 4 years of nonsense can be erased by one sentence full of nonsense. Sure. And it won't be, but that's not to say that it won't be erased. That Kayleigh McEnany is like super young. She's like younger than me. She's gonna be back around and people are gonna have forgotten the things that she did. We need to be Pepperidge Farms in this situation. For this entire 4 year period or close to 5 year period, people will forget. We need to remember. Firewolf Dragon, welcome to Tier 1 membership. Love seeing people sign up for that. We've got big plans. I've really started to look forward to doing the top 10 list. It's something that I've wanted to do for a really long time. We actually did, like one or two on Fridays a long time ago. It's just that they tend to be time consuming because we want to get to as much of the material in a story and provide as much context and additional commentary as possible. But we have a lot of things that we want to comment on. For the top 10 list, I want it to just sort of flow, you know? Anyway, let's see what else is going on. Oh, okay. I love when natural consequences come to bad people. Even though on this case, I guess Mitch McConnell's better. I don't like giving Mitch McConnell credit in the best of times, but when Mitch McConnell is literally trying to slow roll the process that allows nominations for Biden's cabinet, or for the chairman of the Senate committees to be chosen, then I have no interest in giving him any credit. And I look forward not only to, I rejoice in the fact that he's the minority leader now, I look forward to him becoming even more irrelevant when the filibuster is actually passed. And that's a conversation we're gonna have more going forward. That's a big one, we're not dealing with it today, but. So, let's see. Mitch McConnell actually criticized Donald Trump for inciting the Capitol riots and encouraging all of that. And some Republicans, not big fans of that. And they're criticizing him, not all to the same level, and some in weaselier forms than others, but like the Trump base really hates Mitch McConnell right now, despite the fact that he delivered for, you know, whatever Trump wanted. It didn't actually benefit the base, but that's not why they're mad at him. So Lindsey Graham said recently, what we need right now is for Senator McConnell to unequivocally say that the second impeachment of Donald Trump after he leaves office is not only unconstitutional, it's bad for the country, and stand up and fight back. Okay? Rand Paul says, didn't mention McConnell by name, because again, he's a weasel. If Republicans, particularly Republican leadership, goes along with this impeachment, they'll destroy the party. Well, who are you talking about there? Kevin McCarthy? or Mitch McConnell. I mean, it's one of those two, obviously. And Kevin McCarthy, by the way, he's also backpedaling a little bit from previously making clear that Trump is was at least partly responsible for the Capitol riots. Now he's like, no, it's crazy. Nobody could ever say that. Maybe, by the way, because he sees the attacks that Mitch McConnell is facing, and he doesn't want his political career to go poof. Let's see, Senator Kevin Cramer, Republican, stressed that he didn't have a problem with McConnell's comments, but added, I'm hearing a lot of the same criticism from folks back home. He's not just smarter than me, but he's a lot wiser. But there are a lot of people from our base that don't like what he's doing. I defend it, I do, even though I don't share his view. Well, what the fuck is that, honestly? Like, I feel like he's so good and he's so smart, but like, some people are saying he like kind of turned on the president. I'm not saying that. But they're saying that like, it's not helpful at this time. I think it's helpful. But like, they really want him to back off of that, this position I totally defend. It's not my position, but does anyone remember the SNL sketch of, it was like, they would do like Assad's friends from back home or Putin's friends from back home, where they have to like be like totally positive and they start whispering the criticisms. That is the Republican Senate. So they have a problem with him. And there's tons of others. And even outside of politics. So Sean Hannity says, establishment Republicans have no backbone, no principle, no courage, no vision. We need new leadership in the U.S. Senate. All of that, after decades of giving the Republicans whatever they want, Mitch McConnell, he said the mob was fed lies. They were provoked by the president and other powerful people. Get rid of him. Set him on fire. Seriously, that's how quickly they turn. Tucker Carlson warned that Trump voters could see foolish old frauds like Mitch McConnell railing on about how terrible Trump's voters are. Who is the person who's going to stand up and reassure these voters that they're not going to be crushed? Well, unfortunately, Tucker Carlson probably means him. And because we're a celebrity-loving country, he's probably going to win whatever office he goes for. So that's fun. But he's calling Mitch McConnell a foolish old fraud. Because he just said the most obvious thing in the world. Yeah, Trump inspired that. And they know that Trump inspired that. They liked that Trump inspired that. They wanted Trump sending people to the Capitol. God damn, they're such foolish old frauds, all of them. Anyway, Jeff Rutherford says, also, would like to claim Clay Dragon. Well, Jeff Rutherford, you may. I'm feeling benevolent today. A benevolent dragon ruler. Andrew says, with new bills coming to the California legislature mid-February, are you able to recap climate and enviro bills and their authors? A lot of moderate corporate Dems with oil and gas ties hold real power in California. Well, that's 100% right. Okay, good point, actually. And I didn't know that the legislative session was resuming mid-February, but we will definitely look into that, Andrew. Thank you for bringing that up. Derpasaurus, with a big super chat, saying, so I attempted this message 2 weeks ago, but my thumbs weren't as fast as my brain. But I was wanting to join the Dragon Squad, but I'm not a dragon guy. So could I be Derpy Dino? Also, is anyone else scared Biden's going to still not work with us? Well, wait, Derpasaurus, we talked about this, actually. I think I remember that, and I said, of course you can. Nobody needs to, if you want to be in Dragon Squad, you don't have to do anything. And if you don't want to be in Dragon Squad, I get it. It's designed to be obnoxious and nerdy. Most people don't remember, but that was actually the start of it. But no, if you want to be Derpy Dino, you're Derpy Dino. And is anyone else scared Biden's going to still not work with us? Yes. Yes, I do. Dank Dragon brings up a good point. Okay, now we need the AOC emoji. Well, I don't know what the AOC emoji is specifically, but yeah, we should probably have an AOC emoji. I'm going to have to work on that. Jim Chilton says, what surprises me is you're surprised that Kellyanne would not be using alternative facts. No, I'm not surprised that she's doing it, but I'm going to continue doing my job, which is to point it out. The Bitchkin Chicken Dragon says, my husband's almost home with our new puppy. That's the best news. I want one. Teresa says, first Friday that Trump ain't prez. Yeah, it is. This is the first garbage people without Trump as president. Although, like, if you expect that that's going to make a big difference, remember, Trump wasn't often the garbage person. It was very rare, actually. Like, Tucker Carlson was much more common. Actually, my garbage person today, I think, has been more common than Trump anyway. Tyler Crocker, welcome to Tier 2 membership. Enjoy the top 10 lists. RJ Porter, thank you for the super sticker. I appreciate that. I will keep it up. Novelty Dragon says, we can't let seditionists use the First Amendment and Congress to portray themselves as victims. If they speak, they must be contrite. Anything else is just more treason. Yeah, well, I mean, look, certain sorts of speech, sure. If they believe that violent, you know, rallies or whatever, like the sacking of the Capitol is included in that, well, then I definitely disagree. Kofchik says, since you're on TikTok now, you should follow Claudia Conway. She's been documenting all the abuse and posting there. I might have to. I don't really follow anyone yet, but I will. I want to be dragon-ass dragon. Well, you can. Madison Griffin, welcome to Tier 1 membership. Enjoy the emojis and the apparently forthcoming... let's see, we need My Dog Hilo, we need Sprocket, and we need AOC. Stefan says, prelim evidence, new COVID variant more deadly. Okay, I hadn't seen that yet. Wayne Sugihara says, you mentioned Pepperidge Farms, now I'm hungry. I'm hungry too, because all I've had so far today is coffee and juice. Twitch Fixer says, can you say 1% doesn't simply walk into Mordor? Also, can I claim T-Dragon? Thanks for keeping me sane all these years, love from the UK. The 1% doesn't simply walk into Mordor. I can't, it's been a while since I watched it, but you can be T-Dragon. Cyan Lane, welcome to Tier 1 membership. Ray Turner says, John, your shirt is so last year, love Wales. I know, but it's the garbage person shirt. It's all we've got. Mama Bear Dragon says, John, right-wingers turn so quickly because they have no integrity. It's been this way for a long time. Correct. Correct. Kelly Quigley, all the love in the world back to you. Jane Grady says, order Dragon Squad shirt. It's coming next week. Very exciting. I've been wearing mine a lot recently. Erwin Browers, welcome to Tier 1 membership. Thank you so much for that. Faye Dragon, proud progressive rebel scum. I like that. Says, we need to have a Dragon Squad con when the world stops burning. We should cosplay our dragons. We should have board game rooms. That sounds like a lot of fun. Let's do that. Lunar Dragon is still waiting on her 2K shirt. DACA citizenship, expanded Supreme Court, and some legal weed. Some of that coming. There's some good DACA stuff, a little bit, in the executive orders, and supposedly the checks are coming. We'll see about the legal weed in the Supreme Court. Electric Blue Omelet Dragon says, yes to both AOC and Sprocket emojis, please. Oh, they gotta come. Chubtoad says, just order Dragon Squad mug to collect Q tiers. I'm not supposed to promote that yet, but it's there. Penny Wildmore says, rest in peace sci-fi actress Mira Furlan, Danielle Rousseau from Lost, and Delenn from Babylon 5. I actually didn't watch either of those, so I'm not familiar, but yes. R.I.P. Penny Widmore, welcome to Tier 1 membership. Allison says, I'm genuinely worried about Claudia Conway. Yeah, that's been an ongoing thing. Raven Garcia says, I love you. Well, thank you so much. Well, thank you, everybody. I do have to end, though, because I got to get ready. I got to get my garbage person ready. Brett's going to be waiting. But thank you so much for joining me, as always, for the pre-show. The full show's coming up. So you're already here on YouTube. You don't got to go anywhere. You can watch it on YouTube. You can watch it over at twitch.tv/TYT. Also, early heads up that I will be on Common Room later on, and also leading the first hour of the Young Turks. So lots to look forward to. See you in just a few.